It's been 50 years since my father passed away. My dad was a New York City Transit police officer. My father was killed in June of 1967, and I was born in November of 1967. So I never met him. The stories that I've heard about him was that he was gentle, he was humble, he was loving, he was compassionate.
Paul was the one because he used to just make me smile. He didn't really talk about the job much with me because he wanted to protect me from worrying. The boys loved knowing that their father was a police officer. He would come home from work. One of the very first questions that the boys would ask him would be, "Daddy, how many bad guys did you catch today?" Paul would say anywhere from 1 to 100. They always had a lot of fun and he loved them very much.
My fondest memories of Charlie was his love for family and making his children happy, me happy, him being proud of who he was and how he got there and did it on his own. Went into the Marine Corps, served for his country, got on the fire department, never asked for anything. You know, always doing the right thing. What he put into life is what he got out of life. He genuinely loved life.
The amount of courage it takes to be a spouse, they have to say goodbye to their spouse each and every day, not knowing if they're gonna come back. You know, chances are they will, but sometimes they don't.
It was November 4th of 2016. I got a phone call from one of our best friends. She needed to take me to the hospital. I just assumed Paul broke his leg or some other broken bone. I just remember seeing faces, and I just remember yelling that there were too many people here. And I think that's when it really hit me. I think ever since that day, it's been torture. It's been a nightmare that I can't wake up from.
As the son of a firefighter, I know that when my father went to work, I worried about him. All families worry about spouses, fathers, brothers. There's no substitute for courage in this business.
The morning of September 11th, Christina Marie and Brandon was their first day of school. Rebecca was 18 months. And I get a phone call from my sister and she says to me, "You need to turn the TV on to the news." And they showed the first airplane hitting the building. My heart just sunk. As the day progressed, friends and family started coming to the house, waiting for that phone call, and nothing, and nothing.
My father was killed in 1967. By someone he had arrested in 1965. In my house, it was never really spoken of. And on my 21st birthday, my mom gave me his shield, which was inscribed with his name and his date of death. And that's the best gift I've ever gotten in my life. I joined the police department in 1998. I believe that he's with me every day, every day.
With some immediate family and some support from the police department, I sat down with the boys and I explained to them, Daddy got hurt, but Daddy was a hero to strangers and Daddy was our hero.
And I think that is a calling. It's something that you really want to do and you have to make a commitment to do it. You have to be prepared to sacrifice a lot at times. Thank God there are young men and women that are willing to do that.
I think my dad would be tickled. I think that he would be humbled that people reach out to you and help you. And they want to make your life a lot easier. I think he would love it.
Answer the Call has actually watched my kids in the past 16 years grow up. It's like our extended family. We have a bond, and it's very humbling and endearing to know that people still care. They haven't forgotten. They make it a point of honoring someone who has given so much.
I think Answer the Call really fills a void. You know, nothing we do is ever going to bring the fallen officer back, but there's a lot we can do as a department and as a society to fill that void.
When you go to these events, you see people that they have helped years ago, and it's comforting to know that they're always part of the family.
All the supporters need to know how much we appreciate them and how much their contributions, both financially but also emotionally and with their time, mean to families like myself.
From the bottom of my heart is thank you. Thank you for your support. Without that support, Answer the Call couldn't exist, and the help to our families wouldn't be happening.
And I thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for answering the call.